Every year, 64 elite college seniors get an invite to the PIT. With pro contracts at stake, they battle it out in front of top NBA and international scouts. For now, these ballers are still under the radar, underdogs, undrafted.
The BAM testing, we got the best testing in the world right here in Portsmouth, which is awesome.
Weigh them and measure them and do skill testing and get that information to NBA teams.
Which makes this essential part of the NBA scouting.
BAM stands for Basic Athletic Measurement. We're looking at measuring simple athletic movements that are going to relate to performance, goal setting, and benchmarking. That's what we do.
Next level people are starting to put more emphasis on these numbers. But for you guys, as you move on, this is a benchmark to help you get better. I want to check these guys in first.
What they're measuring here is overhead reach. We got to get our baseline to measure how high their vertical actually was. Wingspan, total length of wingspan from fingertip to fingertip. If there's like a 3-inch positive difference in wingspan to their overall height, means is they cover a lot of territory with their arms. So that type of body is just as big a plus as any athleticism.
First one we're going to, a no-step vertical jump. You step in, you can do all the dancing you want, but before you jump, you've got to come to feet still. So it's load and explode. Go straight up. When you go up to reach, don't try and spike like a volleyball player. You're not going to hit the flippers at your apex or the highest point. I want you to reach and touch.
But straight, pure explosion means you have to have your feet set and you cannot move them at all until you jump. And that's what we're measuring here with this particular test. You see, they can't prepare or they can't load as well if they have to stand in place. Now, they can load, you know, obviously, with their quads and their glutes, but it's not the same as getting that pressure down into the ground when you take a little hop step or anything like that. Consequently, this is the truest measure of power.
Here we have our reaction test. It's a random start. You don't know which way you're going to go, right or left. You've got to see it, and you go.
It's very similar to the NFL 5 Pro agility test. It's going to check his peripheral vision. It's going to see how quickly he reacts to that peripheral vision. So it's testing not only speed and agility, but also his reactive time, because guys have to cover back across the lane very quickly when someone penetrates on the other side. So, boom, you got to get across there quick to try to cut off penetration. Okay, right here, this is strictly straight ahead speed.
The clock starts when this back foot leaves the mat. That's the sensor that starts the clock, all right? Boom, clock starts.
For years and years, we're using stopwatches. Well, how exact is that? This is all exact, so you can compare apples to apples.
You got four cones, 19 by 16, okay? It's the NBA lane. You're gonna go all four directions.
So we're looking at four-way agility, forward, backward, side to side. So they start in one corner there, they're running forward, they're sliding to the right, they're running backward, sliding to the left, and then they come back around. So it's a box, basically, that they run in each direction. And what we're measuring, obviously, is the ability to change direction. Changing directions, accelerating and decelerating are all very important components of any sport that involves a lot of reaction, and basketball is definitely one of those.
Tenths, hundredths, thousandths of a second make a big difference. The ultimate goal of BAM is to be the gold standard third party of testing.